Namaste, this is Meghla here from poojas.in and I have with me Shalini ji, our spiritual traditions expert. And because we have Diwali coming up, I thought I'll invite her and get some inputs from her on Diwali, on how we should celebrate Diwali according to her, according to the traditions. And then we will also move to talking about some important shlokas and stotras which we must chant on Deepavali day so that we get maximum benefit of grace. So over to Shalini ji.
Hello Mekla, Jai Mata.
Jai Mata.
So Diwali is a very very famous festival in India and all of us celebrate it.
True.
And all of us celebrate it in different ways, but the most common ways of celebrating it is by lighting diyas, by wearing new clothes, by lighting firecrackers, and general, you know, this festivity of sweets and savories and everybody, you know, the coming of relatives home, and then we celebrate the festival.
Right.
So from the spiritual point of view, what would you like to advise?
Okay, so if you're talking about that first, what I would like to tell is there is this very special shloka called Lakshmi Ashtottara Shatanamavali Stotra. It consists of 17 shlokas, okay, where Ishwara and Parvati have discussed about the glories of Lakshmi. And for people who are in lot of financial struggle and you know, we call it as daridrita. So, and who aspire for more financial success, we recommend this part every Friday as it is.
Okay,
okay, we are at poojas.in continuously for 1 year. We do for many of our clients.
Okay.
Where you know, our priest takes the sankalpa and we do the chants for 100 times. It takes about 3 hours at least if we really chant in great speed.
Yeah.
But otherwise around 4 hours, and then shodashopachara, everything will take 4.5 hours to 5 hours.
Okay.
But for Deepavali particularly, I recommend this particular mantra.
Uh-huh.
See, there are so many Lakshmi related mantras with bijaksharas and all that, but this mantra I have personally tried.
Mm-hmm.
This shloka, and I have done it for more than 6 months.
Okay.
And every week I have seen some improvement in my finances.
Okay.
And it's phenomenal. I anybody in financial distress, I would always recommend this. Any festival also, if you ask me, related to Devi, this is a very good shloka to chant.
And especially more so in Diwali time.
Yeah.
Where we are invoking Mother Lakshmi herself.
Correct, because it's all about prosperity. Diwali is all
true.
About you know, prosperity and richness and bountiness and
yes.
You know,
abundance
everywhere. So Lakshmi Ashtottara Shatanamavali is the best to chant during Diwali.
Okay, wonderful. Yeah, I would also love to hear it and learn it.
Yeah, definitely, I'll teach you.
Yes.
Just to tell you the impact of this particular puja or the, you know, Lakshmi Ashtottara Shatanamavali Stotra is so much that Lord Shiva goes to tell in the Palashruti.
Mm-hmm.
That if you go on chanting for one full year, you know, this 100 times of recitation, by the end of the year you will be equivalent to Kubera.
Oh.
Can you imagine how, because Kubera, we know one thing, he is the one who lent money to Srinivasa in or Tirupati Balaji.
Yes.
So, and all of us, when we put money in the offer as a hundi, kanike, we call it in Kannada, or any donation in the temple, it's all going towards repayment of the debt. That's the most popular belief we all practice.
Yes.
And we know that that's what is happening. So when there is so much abundance in Tirupati and all the money is being repaid to Kubera, can you imagine the richness of Kubera?
He is the god of wealth.
He is the god of wealth and treasures.
Yes.
So, and he lives also very close to Ishwara.
Mm-hmm.
Near Kailas.
Mm.
So you know, that is the whole point. So I am saying that do mantras which are already tried, tested, which are result oriented, then you get confidence.
Yeah.
Like, you know, okay, if I do this, maybe my finances will improve, maybe I can repay my debts, maybe my loan can get sanctioned.
Okay.
Maybe I can buy jewelry, maybe I can buy my own home, you know, avenues just open up in all possible ways, particularly with this these shlokas.
Okay.
and it has an added benefit. You feel very calm and composed, and on Diwali, especially on the Amavasya day, if you chant this, you know, you connect to Devi Lakshmi very instantaneously.
Yeah. Yeah, please go ahead, and I would love to chant with you.
Really? Okay,
yes.
So I will chant it once and you try to repeat it twice.
Okay.
So sure. We will start with the Dhyana Shloka and then all the shlokas.
Mm.
Okay, and anywhere you feel you want me to repeat, I can repeat.
Sure.
Okay. Oh. Devyuvacha,
Devyuvacha,
Deva Deva Mahadeva,
Deva Deva Mahadeva,
Trikalagna Maheshwara,
Trikalagna Maheshwara,
Karunakara Devesha,
Karunakara Devesha,
Bhakta Nukraha Karaka,
Bhakta Nukraha Karaka,
Ashtottara Shatam Lakshmya,
Ashtottara Shatam Lakshmya,
Shrotram Ichhami Tattvashah,
Shrotum Ichhami Tattvatah,
Shrotram Ichhami Tattvashah,
Shrotram Ichhami Tattvashah,
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 yeah. Ashtottara Shatam Lakshmya Shrotram Ichhami Tattvashah.
You want me to repeat it again?
Can you?
Ashtottara Shatam Lakshmya Shrotram Ichhami Tattvashah.
Correct. Ishvara Uvacha,
Ishvara Uvacha,
Devi Sadhu Mahabhage,
Devi Sadhu Mahabhage,
Mahabhagya Pradayakam,
Mahabhagya Pradayakam,
Sarvaishwaryakaram Punyam,
Sarvaishwaryakaram Punyam,
Sarva Papa Pranashanam,
Sarva Papa Pranashanam,
Sarvadaridra Shamanam,
Sarvadaridra Shamanam,
Shravanad Bhukti Muktidam,
Shravanad Bhukti Muktidam,
Rajya Vashyakaram Divyam,
Rajya Vashyakaram Divyam,
Guhyad Guhyatamam Param,
Guhyad Guhyataram Param,
Guhyad Guhya,
Guhyad Guhya
Tamam Param,
Tamam Param,
Durlabham Sarva Devanam,
Durlabham Sarva Devanam,
Chatushashtikalaspadam,
Chatushashtikalaspadam,
Padmadinam,
Padmadinam,
Varantanam,
Varantanam,
Nidhinam,
Nidhinam,
Nityadayakam,
Nityadayakam.
It is Varantanam. Okay, we'll tell again. Padmadinam Varantanam,
Padmadinam Varantanam,
Nidhinam,
Nidhinam,
Nityadayakam,
Nityadayakam,
Samastadeva Samsevyam,
Samastadeva Samsevyam,
Anima,
Anima,
Ashtasiddhidam,
Ashtasiddhidam,
Kimatra,
Kimatra,
Bahunoktena,
Bahunoktena,
Deva Pratyakshakarakam,
Deva Pratyakshakarakam,
Tava Pritya,
Tava Pritya,
Chavakshyami,
Chavakshyami,
Samahita Manashrunu,
Samahita Manashrunu,
Ashtottara Shatasyasya,
Ashtottara Shatasyasya,
Ashtottara Shatasyasya,
Ashtottara Shatasyasya,
Mahalakshmi Studevata,
Mahalakshmi Studevata,
Klim Bija,
Klim Bija,
Padamityuktam,
Padamityuktam,
Shaktistu Bhuvaneshwari,
Shaktistu Bhuvaneshwari,
Anganyasakaranyasaha,
Anganyasakaranyasaha,
Sa Ityadi Prakirtitaha,
Sa Ityadi Prakirtitaha,
Athadhyanam,
Athadhyanam.
So when we are chanting 100 times, we don't have to chant this, you just chant the whatever I taught first, just once.
Okay.
And then Athadhyanam once.
Okay.
After the Dhyana shlokas are over, the actual shlokas will begin.
Okay.
That you have to chant 100 times.
Okay.
So okay.
Fine.
Vande Padmakaram,
Vande Padmakaram,
Prasannavadanam,
Prasannavadanam,
Saubhagyadam, Bhagyadam,
Saubhagyadam, Bhagyadam,
Hastabhyam Abhayapradam,
Hastabhyam Abhayapradam,
Hastabhyam Abhayapradam,
Hastabhyam Abhayapradam,
Maniganair,
Maniganair,
Nana Vidhair,
Nana Vidhair,
Bhushitam,
Bhushitam,
Bhakta Bhishta,
Bhakta Bhishta,
Phalapradam,
Phalapradam,
Harihara,
Harihara,
Brahmadi Bhissevitam,
Brahmadi Bhissevitam,
Parshwe Pankaja,
Pashve Pankaja
Shankha Padma Nidibhir
Shankha Padma Nidibhir
Yuktam
Yuktam
Sada Shakti Bihi
Sada Shakti Bihi
Shakti Bihi
Shakti Bihi
Sarasi Janayane
Sarasi Janayane
Saroja Haste
Saroja Haste
Dhavalataram
Dhavalataram
Shuka Gandha Malya Shobhe
Shuka Gandha Gandha Malya Shobhe
Shuka Gandha Malya Shobhe
Shuka Gandha Malya Shobhe
Bhagavati Hari Vallabhe
Bhagavati Hari Vallabhe
Manogne
Manogne
Tribhuvana Bhutikari
Tribhuvana Bhutikari
Prasida Mahyam
Prasida Mahyam.
So here the Dhyana Shloka concludes. Now we begin the Ashtottara Shatanamavali.
Okay.
Om.
Om.
Prakritim Vikritim Vidyam.
Prakritim Vikritim Vidyam.
Sarva Bhuta Hita Pradam.
Sarva Bhuta Hita Pradam.
Shraddham Vibhutim Surabhim.
Shraddham Vibhutim Surabhim.
Namami Paramatmikam.
Namami Paramatmikam.
Vacham Padmalayam.
Vacham Padmalayam.
Padmam
Padmam.
Shuchim Swaham.
Shuchim Swaham.
Shuchim Swaham.
Shuchim Swaham.
Swadham Sudham.
Swadham Sudham.
Dhanyam.
Dhanyam.
Hiranmayim Lakshmim.
Hiranmayim Lakshmim.
Nitya Pushtam Vibhavarim.
Nitya Pushtam Vibhavarim.
Aditim Chaditim Deeptam.
Aditim Chaditim Deeptam.
Aditim Chaditim
Aditim Chaditim
Deeptam
Deeptam
Vasudham
Vasudham
Vasudharinim
Vasudharinim
Namami Kamalam Kantam
Namami Kamalam Kantam
Kamakshim
Kamakshim
Kshirasambhavam
Kshirasambhavam
Anugraha Pradam Buddhim
Anugraham Pradam Buddhim
Anugraha Pradam Buddhim
Anugraha Pradam Buddhim
Anagham Harivallabham
Anagham Harivallabham
Ashokam Amritam
Ashokam
Amritam
Amritam
Deeptam
Deeptam
Lokashoka Vinashinim
Lokashoka Vinashinim
Namami Dharma Nilayam
Namami Dharma Nilayam
Karunam Lokamataram
Karunam Lokamataram
Padma Priyam
Padma Priyam
Padmahastam
Padmahastam
Padmakshim
Padmakshim
Padmasundarim
Padmasundarim
Padmodbhavam
Padmodbhavam
Padmamukhim
Padmamukhim
Padmanabhapriyam Ramam
Padmanabhapriyam Ramam
Padmamaladharam
Padmamalam dharam
Padmamaladharam
Padmamaladharam
Devim
Devim
Padminim
Padminim
Padmagandhinim
Padmagandhinim
Punyagandham
Punyagandham
Suprasannam
Suprasannam
Prasadabhimukhim
Prasadabhimukhim
Prabham
Prabham
Namami Chandravadanam
Namami Namami Chandravadanam
Chandram Chandrasahodarim
Chandram Chandrasahodarim
Chaturbhujam Chandrarupam
Chaturbhujam Chandrarupam
Indiram Indushitalam
Indiram Indushitalam
Ahladajananim
Ahladajananim
Pushtim
Pushtim
Shivam
Shivam
Shivakarim Satim
Shivakarim Satim
Vimalam Vishwajananim
Vimalam Vishwajananim
Tushtim Daridranashinim
Tushtim Daridranashinim
Pita Pushkarinim Shantam
Pita Pushkarinim Shantam
Pita Pushkarinim Shantam
Pita Pushkarinim Shantam
Shuklamalyambaram Shantam Shriyam
Shukla Malyambaram Shriyam
Bhaskarim Bilva Nilayam
Bhaskarim Bilva Nilayam
Bhaskarim Bilva Nilayam
Bhaskarim Bilva Nilayam
Vararoham Yashaswinim
Vararoham Yashaswinim
Vasundharam Udarangam
Vasundharam Udarangam
Harinim Hemamalinim
Harinim Hemamalinim
Dhanadhanyakarim Siddhim
Dhanadhanyakarim Siddhim
Straina Saumyam Shubhapradam
Straina Saumyam Shubhapradam
Nripaveshmagatanandam
Nripaveshmagatanandam
Varalakshmim Vasupradam
Varalakshmim Vasupradam
Shubham Hiranyaprakaram
Shubham Hiranyaprakaram
Samudratanayam Jayam Samudratanayam Jayam
Namami Mangalan Devim
Vishnu Vakshasthalasthitam
Vishnu Patnim Prasannakshim
Narayana Samashritam Daridhyadvamsinim Devim
Sarvopadravavarinim
Navadurgam Mahakalim
Brahma Vishnu Shivatmikam
Brahma Vishnu Shivatmikam
Trikalagnyana Sampannam
Namami Bhuvaneshwarim
Lakshmim Kshira Samudra Rajatanayam
Shri Ranga Dhameshwarim
Dasi Bhuta Samasta Deva Vanitam
Lokaika Deepankuram
Shriman Mandakataksha
Labdha Vibhava
Brahmendra Gangadharam
Tvam Trailokya Kutumbinim
Sarasijam
Vande Mukunda Priyam
Matar Namami Kamale
Kamalayataakshi
Shri Vishnu Hrut Kamala Vasini
Vishwamatah
Kshirodaje
Kamala Komala Garbha Gauri
Lakshmi Prasida
Satatam
Namatam Sharanye
So till here you have to chant 100 times.
Okay.
After that this actual Phalashruti begins.
Mm-hmm.
So where he tells what will happen if you chant 3 times.
Okay.
What will happen if you chant 1 year. That you chant only once.
Okay.
Trikalam yo japet vidvan
Shanmasam
Vijitendriyah
Daridrya dhvamsanam
Kritva
Sarvam apnoti yatnatah
Devi nama sahasreshu Punya ashtottaram shatam
Yena shriyam avapnoti
Koti janma daridratah
Bhrguvare shatam dhi
धीमान
भृगुवारे शतम धीमान
पठेद्वत्सरमात्रकम् अष्टैश्वर्यमवाप्नोति कुबेर इव भूतले दारिद्र्यमोचनम् नाम
श्रोत्रमम्बापरं शतम्
स्तोत्रमम्बापरं शतम् भुक्त्वा तु विपुलान् भोगान् स्यासायुज्य
आप्नुयात्
प्रातः काले पठे नित्यम् सर्वदुःखोपशान्तये पठन्स्तु चिन्तये
देवीं
सर्वाभरणभूषितां
जगदम्बार्पणमस्तु.
सो ऐ विल् जस्ट् गिव् यु टिप्स् in this, you know what happens is, in this space if you chant, you'll be chanting the whole day, but in this space you have to learn, then only you can learn proper, you know, without mistakes. And why we say jagadambarpanamastu is because we make mistakes, alpa prana maha prana, the meaning changes, and you know, when we don't split the words properly, you know, we make mistakes. We just offer everything to mother, she takes care. And the beauty is, when you're chanting this, you can just close your eyes and meditate on Lakshmi with all jewels bedecked, you know, then you connect to her faster. That's what the shloka also says. So you know, when you're chanting, just chant and imagine that she's appeared in front of you with all the jewels. Like that you have to chant. And you know, the pace is like this: prakritim vikritim vidyam sarva bhutahita pradam shraddham vibhutim surabhim namami paramatmikam vacham padmalayam padmam. Like that you have to chant, then you will be able to finish in 3 hours. Okay, and don't try to split the word, and like, you know, like how we did now, one line you should
not
split.
This is only for learning.
And when you start splitting, it takes time.
Yeah. And the more we say, the fluency also
will develop.
Improves.
Yeah, it's very powerful.
Yes.
And these are just tips what I tried to do, and you know, I improvised every week.
Mm-hmm.
And new techniques. You know, at a stretch, it's best to sit and finish.
Yes.
But I have my clients who ask me, can I do, 20 in the morning, 40 in the afternoon, and the remaining, you know. Like that you can split and do.
Okay.
The results, I have seen the best results when I have sat and completed the chants of 100 times in one shot.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah. Mm. And every week, I promise you, you will definitely see improvement in your finances, in your wealth quotient, in abundance and prosperity.
And if you have to chant it on a regular basis, when do you do it?
You can do it anytime, because you know, they say, you know, Trikalam, you can morning, afternoon, evening. When you actually chant like that, you will, even once if you chant 3 times a day, you will become a Jitendriya, like you will gain victory over your senses, you will become a scholar, everything is there in the shloka only.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you can chant anytime.
Wonderful.
With bath, without bath, anything is okay.
Thank you so much, Mikla.
You're
I learned
welcome.
A beautiful shloka because of you. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. And the whole point is to pass it on.
Yes.
And you know, the more you give, the more you receive. That's what our guru Nimishananda Guruji says. Don't hold back.
Yes.
Nobody, whatever you're destined to get, nobody can steal it from you. At the same time, if you share also, you're not going to be a pauper or something, because you shared a secret. It's not a secret, it's something which Shiva told Parvati, so that the whole world knows, and the more people sing her glories, the better it is.
Yes.
Yeah.
Greater the happiness for the entire world. The more we share, the more we, you know, that internal peace and happiness increases in us.
Absolutely. And you know, if you see somebody suffering, and even if you have all the riches with you, how will you, you won't even feel like enjoying what you have, right?
Yes.
I mean, you have everything and you still can't, when you see somebody suffering, you feel sad.
Yeah, true. Absolutely.
Yeah. That's how it is. So we both of us wish you a very, very happy Diwali.
Happy Diwali, and may Mother Lakshmi's blessings be on everyone.
Yes. And now over to Shalini ji for the tradition aspect of it. The mantra aspect, the shloka aspect is done. So let's switch to the other aspect.
So I wanted to know what is it that is something that you want to convey for this Diwali? What do you think our viewers should follow from your perspective?
See, every Diwali, most of us are always, you know, like on the, it has been a part of our tradition that we have to clean the house, we have to keep, you know, that kind of a cleanliness all around us.
Yeah.
That is there in our tradition already. Many people, you know, paint their houses, do the cleaning of, thorough cleaning of all their, you know, house items and things like that. That is a part of our tradition. But besides that, there are many things which Pooja Guruji advises us to do. See, each one of us, we are living in a certain space. So we have our environment. In that environment, in that that space that we are living in, we as the body, we as the mind, we as the intellect, and we as the soul. There are so many different aspects to our personality. So in each aspect, Pooja Guruji has advised us so many things. As far as the environment is concerned, Guruji says that you have to, you know, keep your environment very, very clean. Keep regularly dusting and cleaning the entire outside premises of your house. And first of all, wash the you know, the front yard of the house with water every morning, so that all the negativities which have accumulated during the day are washed away. We apply rangoli. We apply, you know, like the toran that we say with mango leaves, because mango leaves are very, very powerful in attracting positive energy, is what has been told as part of the Indian tradition. And also, if it is available, nothing like, you know, like putting the cow dung, which is the very natural antiseptic and is the receptor of all divine vibrations. So when we just even a small handful of cow dung, if we keep it on our doorstep, so that it purifies the environment in and around the house.
So do we have to make it into a ball or something?
Yes, yes, you make it into a ball and keep it on both sides of the, you know, the doorstep, and put a flower on top of it, and we have to rever it as Mother Lakshmi herself, because the cow, as we all know, is the, she is the, contains all the divine energies of all the 33,000 crore forms of divinity that we have in our Sanatana Dharma. All those forms of gods reside in the cow.
Kamadhenu.
So whatever Kamadhenu, whatever she gives, is you know, filled with divine vibrations. So if we cannot tie a cow in our house, which is becomes very, very difficult in the city life, so what we can do is to get some little bit of gober or whatever cow dung that we get, put it on the doorstep, put flowers and apply haldi and kumkum and worship it as Mother Lakshmi herself, that she is the one who is going to attract all the positive and the divine energies into our house. So when we do that, you know, making the outside very divine and pure, we attract God's energy.
So assuming, because a lot of them now reside in apartments.
Yes.
So actually washing with water may not be possible. Can we just wipe it with
a wet cloth?
Possible?
And yes, yes, definitely. And we can put the rangoli, not with the sticker rangoli, not with the plastic one.
What about the chalk piece?
No, not even that is that is also not recommended. It is said that the, you know, that the rangoli powder, white powder that we get in the market,
yeah,
that is ideal.
Okay.
So that is made out of limestone, and that when it is applied is supposed to be very, very
auspicious. Okay.
So when we decorate our, you know, the door, main door of the house,
mm-hmm,
with flower garlands, with mango leaves, with rangoli and with the cow dung, it is, we are making preparations for inviting
Lakshmi
into our house.
Fantastic.
So with that, then we are now into the house. Now that house is thoroughly cleaned, thoroughly decluttered, because, you know, like all of us have the habit of, you know, collecting, buying.
Yeah.
But we are not in the same habit of, you know, discarding all the unwanted stuff or all the unnecessary things. So the first thing is that we declutter our house, remove all the things that are not required, give it away to people who are actually in need of it. And when we declutter our house, there is more space available. And when there is space available, there is free passage of air. And when there is free passage of air, there is the atmosphere inside the house is much healthier.
Right.
And it also gives way for the vibrations, because there is no clutter. It feels lighter, yeah. And there is more light, there is more energy inside the house.
So you're saying the vibration of the house will change when we actually discard things which we don't use?
Exactly. Okay. So clearing up of the storage, all the lofts and the attics that we have in the house.
Under the bed. Cupboards.
Yes, the cleaning, everything. It requires a massive amount of time and energy. So I think we should start off much earlier in preparation for, making the house absolutely clean, clear. That the message of Diwali is clean and clear.
Clear, yeah, true.
So we clean everything and we clear up all the space. So that is one thing which is very important, washing off all the linen and washing the curtains and cleaning everything. I mean, all that is all comprehensive under the word clean. So that, and then we come to ourselves. Now we are living in that purified atmosphere of the house, and how do we, that aspect of us we tend to neglect. How to make ourselves clean and clear of all the negativities that are there in our mind, in our feelings. So
mother, how about the body?
Yeah, we'll come to that. First is we start with the body.
Yeah,
body we have to keep clean. As we all know, we are all very conscious about the hygiene part of it. So we always, like as Indians, we take bath at least once a day, if not twice. And we keep our body in proper, everybody is health conscious and everybody is hygiene conscious nowadays. So that aspect is already taken care of. And where we eat good food, we eat nutritious food, and the body has to have its full vigor and vitality. So that aspect is sort of taken care of in the day-to-day this thing, living. But when we come to our mind, that is where the problem is. So it has been advised in all the scriptures that we have to clear our mind of all our negativities that we have inside, as anger, as millions of negative feelings that we have, hatred, resentments, and likes and dislikes, and all that which comes in the way of our peace and happiness has to be discarded.
Yeah, these negative emotions definitely block our growth.
Yes.
And intuition, ideas, everything actually.
Yes, our entire potential, as Pooja Guruji tells us, is not brought up to the highest extent because of all those layers and layers of negative emotions that are there present in us.
They're all clutter in the mind.
They're the clutter in the mind. So we have to clean and clear the mind.
Yeah.
So that again is a very important aspect of how to develop awareness of where we are going wrong.
Right.
Where is that wrong feeling? Where is that wrong thought? Where is that wrong kind of action that we are doing?
Yeah.
So Diwali is also about awareness about our internal state. So how to declutter our mind, mm-hmm. and how to make our inner, completely clean and clear.
Yeah.
And when we are clean and clear, that divine grace flows through and through. Mm-hmm. So the ideal we should be aiming for this Diwali.
Yeah, and one more physical aspect I can recall from Pooja Guruji's satsangs,
yes.
is that we must use haldi.
Correct.
Can you just elaborate on that?
Haldi and kumkum are both plant-based. So they have the capacity to absorb the divine vibrations of divinity itself. So it has that very sattvic effect. It has got a very calming effect, of a very cooling effect on our system. So in fact, on Naraka Chaturdashi, it is said that we have to have a Mangal Snan. That Mangal Snan is, applying haldi, chandan and kesar all over the body, rejuvenate the skin, the process of applying haldi on your body, it is very, not only beauty enhancing, but also it enhances the well-being in us.
Yeah.
So
it also gets the, yeah, like you said, it's not just beauty enhancing.
Yes, it is well-being enhancer.
Now the concept of beauty has changed.
Yeah.
But I think people are ready to do certain things to, you know, welcome prosperity. And healthy is associated with prosperity.
Yes.
So if you want prosperity in your home, you have to be attractive. Just like, you know, to look attractive, you'd use cosmetics like that to attract divine energies. Haldi and kumkum are things which you should use, and haldi particularly, you can just smear it all over your body, the ladies particularly.
Yeah.
And then take a bath, so then your vibration change. So automatically you are in the attraction mode, not, yeah, you are not distracted and you are not repelling. So that is the beauty of haldi.
True, absolutely.
Yeah. Anything you would like to say on a concluding note for Diwali for our viewers?
I think, you know, like body, mind and soul, we have to be completely clean and clear and keep our environment clean and clear, the surroundings around us. And then we will be able to attract divine energies, divine grace into all of us. So that is the very important thing for Diwali, because that light within us has to shine, because Diwali is all about light, not only light as external, when we light the diyas, but also that internal light has to shine. So that internal light shines only when we are absolutely clean and clear.
And from my end, I would like to say, just attract, that's all. Just be on the mode of attracting people, attracting wealth, attracting opportunities.
Good luck.
Fortune.
Prosperity.
And for that to happen, you have to be clean and
clear.
Yeah. Thank you so much. We wish you all a very, very,
very happy Diwali.
Wish you prosperity.
Jai Mata.
Namaste.